Promise, my twin. Oscar Hardwick, actually, with a surname like that, you probably are my twin. Anything else you'd like to add, sir?
Not really, just saying I've been watching the broadcast a lot in the car and you've been doing a brilliant job as always.
It's strange not having you doing cameraman extraordinaire and I'm actually having to press buttons and do stuff, so apologies if the camera's crap, because it's me. So, yeah, all is good in the world. And we're on lap 88 now, so I don't know what that is in bingo terms. 88 fat people, not sure. And that was a switch of position for 10th there, just while I look at that. Who's that? That is Jarno Hodgewedge up into 10th because Casper Mortensen has just left the pits. So that's all sorted that one out. Anyway, feel free to stay if you want to and chip in various comments. More than welcome. Who else have we got going on? In fact, now that I've actually talked about beer, I feel like I should go and grab one. So, let's see. We've got Simon Mellish has escaped. Yeah. obviously, the name, the calling of beer, is no good. Dear. Right. So, Mr. S in the chat room says he's never played R Factor before.
You're missing out.
He is missing out. Tell us exactly. He says, does it have AI cars? Noob question. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about R Factor for someone who's never done it before, because there are people that come and watch this who basically they see their mate statuses on Facebook.
Yeah.
And just go,
most of my friends don't know what R Factor is. And R Factor is...
How would you describe it to them?
I would call it a really good indie game in the start. Because when R Factor came out first, I've never heard of it. And I never heard of them either. So, but maybe people who are in the gaming industry more than I have heard about IC before, but well, R Factor is, I think it's a really good game because of the mods. Because the base package could be quite boring. I don't know what you think.
I hope that didn't end with a question, because I was just grabbing my first beer.
Also, all these mods and all the series driven in the R-Factor community makes it a quite interesting game. It could last forever, actually.
yeah, potentially, yeah, because where anything is user generated, it's always as good as the community that it is. So, potentially, I mean, we were talking about the Jeff Cameron games and stuff like that. They've got mods that just keep going on and on and on and on. So long as there's a community that supports it, it can potentially stay on forever and ever and ever. And it's where it's user-generated, and I suppose the servers, you pay for your own space and stuff. Unlike my big bugbear for console games, you're at no risk of the servers being shut down. Because I know with, not necessarily F1 games, but there's a couple of racing games that I watch. Is that someone into the pits? I can't remember who we're watching, actually. It's Hodgewedge in from what is now 11th position, because Casper Mortensen is through. So Jarno not having a good time. and Kevin Nadeau's in from 9th as well, just on the front of the screen. Welcome to the race, Gel Stenbeck for 05 Motorsports in third place as well. Let's bring him up. Excuse me. Any game that that the server is controlled by other people, as soon as the server is shut down, no one bothers with that game anymore. Oh, bloody cough. There we go. Sorted.
Yeah.
And, yeah, that always has a shelf life, whereas with this, potentially, there isn't one. I can only think of another game that's lasted for quite such a long time that's kind of user-generated, and that would be Trackmania.
Yeah, that's true, that's true.
I've not played Trackmania for about a year and a half. In fact, tomorrow I'm now going to go and play it, because I used to love that.
I've actually never played Trackmania.
Do you know what? I used to play Trackmania every day before I got into R Factor. I used to be in the top, 200 players in the world. I was like, yay! And there's, I think there's about a million. And I was like, yay! Because all you had to do was, because I used to play with the faithful arrow keys, you just used to press forward and then hope for the best. But, yeah, great game, great game. I wouldn't call it a sim.
A real arcade game.
Yeah, all is good in the world.
Yeah. And also, you have the race series, Race 07.
Yeah, yeah.
STCC GTR.
And plus, you've got as Bradley was just saying, he's in the top 20. Oh, this cough. I'm so sorry, everyone. I've been so ill for so long, and I don't want to miss out on broadcast. I think that's Davey Laurie's is just saying GTR 2 is the other one that's gone on for years and years as well. So it is great to see. I still see stuff pop up occasionally for F1 Challenge, which was a bit late 90s. So yeah, there's some great communities that are out there. So. Always good to see. Joe Stenbeckman in third, 05 Motorsports. Nearly 2 minutes down on the leader, but because they've been in for the pits and had a driver change, that must mean that Helston and John Davies is in from second place for Atlantic.
Yeah,
in fact,
James
he's just
Davies
leaving.
Is on his way up now. Roy is in the pits making a driver swap.
So. Ooh. Kick him out of his chair.
It's 3 seconds left, so I'm a little bit late. And there they go.
Da, 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 da. What position are they in these days?
17th.
Ah, HG Hansen back in the wheel.
Yep.
They had a lot of pit stops at the very beginning of the race. What was going on there, do you know?
Not sure about the start, but I know they had some spins and hit the wall a couple of times. And then the plan was originally to have a driver swap every second hour, I think, because one tank of fuel lasts for about an hour. But Roy does know more about that than me.
So we pop on board with Ryan Walker in 26th position. No, it's not Ryan Walker at all, don't mind me. We are watching. HG. In 17th position for RMI Motorsports, and there you can see just exactly how little you see in the darkness.
Yeah.
Excuse me. So, and that corner's caught out a few people so far. So that's the timings at the moment. There's last lap round coming up on your screens in a second. Once I actually click on the right button. There we go. I tell you what, I do like playing. I don't know why, because I don't watch the sport at all. NASCAR games.
I actually like the old ones, where you can drive the 80s cars and 70s cars.
So I
had this NASCAR Historic Racing or something.
Oh, okay.
You can drive the Fleming Superbird and Lotus. Oh, that was good fun. There was also a functioning safety car there.
Yes. Yeah. Because, I've just been playing, it wasn't released in Europe, the Eutechnics NASCAR season 2011. And it's actually quite good for the PS3. I've enjoyed it. I'm surprised it was not. Well, I'm not surprised it wasn't released over here because there's not really a popularity or a popular version of it. There's Eddie Holgren's in the pits from 8th position. And yeah, it's just. What am I doing? Come on. There we go. That's the right button. There's Marcel Vischer. Gregory de Greef is in too, just taking over the Black Rebels car from Kevin Ledeau. yeah, it's. I just think because it's such a close combat racing in a way, you're always kept on your toes, even though you are just going around in a circle.
One more time. Roy was speaking to me.
I know, it's just it's because there's so much going on in the space of just a couple of corners, and there's always cars about you, you're always kept on your toes, and I just think that makes for a good gaming experience, even if you do just turn left.
Yeah, that's true.
Might be just me, I'm not sure. who remembers NASCAR 2003, I think it was, for the PC? That was an awesome game.
I don't.
Okay. Yeah, strange. Oh dear, what other games can I think of that I've enjoyed over the years?
Katamari, or was it?
We love Katamari! Sure, I was introducing that to my other half the other day, and that was hilarious, because I was like, this is awesome. You commented on my Project Diva videos on Facebook.
Yeah.
That's a dodgy game. F197, Oscar Hardwick, I so agree. I loved that game when it came out. I remember being at school and doing this, I'm so ill, mummy. And then she'd be like, okay, have the day of school. And I was like, right, 100% races. So that was awesome. What else can I think of? I'm just trying to think of anything that's non... Does anyone have any non-racing games that they love to play? And if anyone says Call of Duty, I might just shoot you all. But
I'd love Honor.
No! Joe, I love gaming in general, but I really do not get on with first-person shooters. I don't know why.
You should try Natural Born Killers.
What's that? Tell everyone.
It's a really, really old indie game. It's a first-person shooter, but you shoot small and cuddly animals.
Oh!
You can go around and shoot chickens and rabbits.
Oh, bless!
Oh, it was good fun. And the Deer Hunter games?
Oh, Cabela.
Yeah. Not Cabela. I don't like Cabela, but the other types. The one where you don't have a mission. Just go out in the woods and shoot animals.
Mm-hmm. Just
you mean the game from like late 90s where you couldn't even move, you could just go in a circle?
Who the hell is that?
No, not that one.
Oh, it's Brent, it's Birthday Boy!
Yay!
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to
you're
you.
Have to dance as well. I need some music here, guys. Come on.
if I break beat it, Joachim can sing it.
Well, after my stint, I expect a rap and everything.
Yo, Brandon, it's your birthday. It's your birthday. It's your birthday.
Dubstep rap.
Pretty good. Yeah. Pretty good. Yeah. Dubstep.
Was it Warren
DJ? Maybe he can throw up something.
Yeah.
Awesome. So, how is Birthday Boy doing today? And what did you get? Did you get anything nice?
The satisfaction of turning 27. That's what I got.
Oh, but I had that last year, so that is all. I feel your pain.
Still a couple of years for me, so.
Sharp.
I'm feeling good. No, to be honest with you, I embrace getting older. I embrace being wiser in life, and it seems like you know, you just take life the way it is. You know, you gotta realize when you got something good and you enjoy it, because everything changes.
So true. And I think around this time of life, I've noticed the last, I'd say, 2 to 3 years in general, because I'm 27 as well. It's just where things kind of start to just click into place, and then I've noticed this last year I've just been like slightly zen in like, I'm quite happy with how I've now got things, this is good, and then you just start enjoying things.
Yeah, I think you start getting so anxious about life and all the silly things that, you know, people just blow up over, and they shouldn't at all. So yeah, it's good to learn those things, and it's good to be in that position where you're like,
that is
sure
true.
There's the, you know, people who are 10 years older than us being like, oh god, they'll learn.
Yeah, they'll learn. 40 is the new 70. Yeah. So that means that actually, now that we are zen in the age of 27, we should be the only people who don't shout and scream at everyone at a public McGann Renault server.
yeah, and we won't have to reincarnate, so it's all good.
I want to come back again. I want to try things.
Well, you better start, like, oh no. Just being an asshole.
Start.
People steal things, you know. You'll be able to reincarnate all you want. I mean, not guarantee what you're going to reincarnate as, but...
Probably the person who I've been really horrible to.
Yeah.
Must not kill people would be good. Welcome to the race, Attila Kish in 7th position for Simco Hungarian team while we're chatting away. And also Esben Tipple, 13th position for Arthur R. Massive, is having a tipple himself, I think. Out in 13th, he's 5th, 6th overall in the P2 class, so not doing bad in 13th position. Welcome to the race for him. So that's all good. But yeah, so any other plans for the rest of the day for your birthday?
Well, you know,
a lot of people
are gone this weekend, so, and I'm terrible at planning things ahead of time for my birthday and stuff. I'm just like, yeah, you know, it's my birthday, so I'm probably going to get a bunch of people, go to the bar tonight, I don't know, I might go out to St. Louis, something like that, so, we'll see how it goes. I'll let you know how it goes after the fact.
Awesome, and then how about today's race, obviously, how's it going for you?
Well, I haven't started yet. I haven't jumped in at all. This is my first race with World Connect competition. It might be a one-off. It might be something a bit more, because I haven't been sim racing. I haven't been sim racing for a while, actually. So this is my first major race that I've come to. And I got to say, man, these guys, Marcel, Artur, and Richard, have put in quite an effort, and we did a lot of preparation going into it, and they're the type of guys that if you want something to be planned out way ahead of time, and you want to have that sort of comfortable feeling when you're driving, these are the guys to be with. And we made a setup mistake, we went with a 3-wing on the back when everybody else is doing 1-wing, so that's why we're so slow in the straights. But right now, with so many DNFs in the GT2 class, it's paying off. So at least I'd rather have a stable, consistent, and setup that's a lot more predictable than, you know, go into a race and be really fast, but then just crash out 5 hours into it. I would break things.
That's true, actually. I so agree, because I mean, that's how I set up my car. I don't go for an unstable one that's quicker, because I know that I will bin it at some point, so I'd rather go for a stable, especially in an endurance race like this. So I know, it's good. It's good to see you out and about doing some sim racing again. Hopefully it will get your bug bitten so that you want to come back and do some more. But we've got Arthur on screen at the moment for World Connect competition. You're on 22nd of the 27 teams that are still going, just approaching lap 40. You've got Jan Wimensing for SRVN about 10 seconds behind you, so feeling pressured at the moment, or do you think that's under wraps for now? Under control?
We got a good plan. We're fuel saving and everything's going according to plan so far. There hasn't been any hiccups except for getting hit in the first part of the race. Marcel, actually, we were trying to do a driver swap, and he forgot to highlight Arturo's name, so he had to do an extra hour. And just yesterday, punishment. He was like, you know, I don't want to do 3 hours. I mean, it's possible, but I'm not doing 3 hours. And he ends up doing 3 hours right away.
There you go. You should never say what you don't want.
I like racing with somebody else, to be honest with you. It keeps me on my toes, rather than have, you know, be out there in a blank, dark night, and, you know, trying to see if your pace is really there or not. It's good to have somebody pressure you, or you pressuring somebody. It keeps you on your toes, keeps you alive. So, I look forward to it. I'll be going in next after Richard finishes his stint in about sometime soon. Sim racing, I've only been out of it for a couple months. It's not like I've been gone forever. But I am a little bit rusty.
It's all good. It's all good. Lovely. Well, good luck. I hope everything goes well for the rest of the day, and enjoy the rest of your birthday day weekend, and make sure everyone knows about it so you get lots of good stuff.
Yeah, make sure everybody knows about it so they don't hit me. That's my gift.
The gift of a victory.
Don't hit me on the track.
You should have birthday skin on
there. Exactly. We need to have a special skin with like party balloons and like ribbons and stuff all over it.
Slow me down on the straight some. Damn balloons. Makes no sense.
Awesome. Cool. Well, take care, mate, and then we'll catch up with you soon, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah, and before I go, Simon, it's good. I didn't know you were going to be announcing for this race, so it's good to have you doing this. I know it's quite the task, 12 hours, but appreciate what you do for us.
Oh, thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to do it for you all, because you're also awesome. So, the love fest continues. I can hear Joachim coughing. Is he about to do his normals?
No.
Okay. Cool.
I just felt less.
No, Joachim, and Roy as well, who's now joined us. But you're awesome as well.
Yeah, we know. We're just shining in your shadow.
No. We couldn't do it without anyone. Just a quick rundown of actually the games that people were chatting about. I'm going to click on archive because some of it's now gone. But there were some great games that people needed to... it's gone a bit wrong. People mentioning Magicka, which is a great little PC game. Good if you go round to a couple of other people to... A bit like a dungeon crawling RPG type thing. Do you know what? I can't play Skyrim because at the very beginning, I bought it on PS3 and there's a bug on it, and the dragon flew backwards. And I thought, do you know what? I'm not even going to try this. So it's gone to the it's gone to the bottom of my list. So that way, it's pretty good. Mass Effect people have done. Minesweeper is harder than Call of Duty on Veteran.
Minecraft.
Yeah. Someone's put Crayon Physics Diner Deluxe. Awesome game. Love that. I did see Halo Legendary is a joke. Halo 1 remake. Prince of Persia. Yeah. Free Space 1 and 2. I've not tried those, to be honest.
GoldenEye for Nintendo 64. That's the greatest game ever.
Descent, Mario 3. X-Wing Alliance. Yeah, good stuff. It's nice, actually, to see you're talking about different genres and stuff, and that not everyone is just like, must play Octane. Pineapple Smash Crew, yes, great indie game. I've only just started. I bought it and I've installed it. I've yet to actually run it, but I was watching a playthrough of someone on YouTube doing it. I'm going to chuck in VVVVVV, if anyone's ever played that. Roy's in the house, everybody! Woo! How's it going, Roy? How's your stim?
Awful. Right from the beginning till the end, awful.
Oh, no.
First thing I did was smack the car into the wall, and from there it went downhill.
From there, it went downhill?
Oh, yeah.
Oh dear.
Could barely reach 300 kilometers an hour down the straight. So, well, I did see two GT cars when I started my stint, and that was all the GT cars I did see. So, nah, not very good, and I had a bucket load of spins. My car was so twitchy.
I think you are the first one on this race to have a head-on collision.
Well, a head-on collision when he did Someone's touch my left rear wheel.
Someone had to do it and be the first person to a head full on crash into the wall.
Yeah. And a big sorry to I don't remember who I spun ahead of either.
He was in fourth position earlier.
It was a bit the Esprit.
Yeah. He was the one who hit you in the front. Yeah.
It hit me and I think got a puncture or something because of that when I had spin right in front of him.
There was a driver swap after the crash, so I think it...
Oh! John Davies is facing the wrong way. Sorry to interrupt you. Second position, John Davies spinning coming out of one of the corners and collected by Dennis Porcupine. Can't remember his surname.
Poroknek?
That's the one. And that's the problem there for the second position man, because that's going to potentially drop him behind Joel Stenbeck when they have to do all of their pit stops and stuff. So, John Davies, let's see if I can get a replay of that. I'm not sure if I can. Let's see what we've got. No, I don't think we can. Sorry, Will.
We're going so fast.
We were! That's Simon's speed, that is. But he's coming up to lap Poroknik again. But he just lost it coming out of the corner and then was just kind of helpfully nudged along by Dennis. What are the same? It was done with love, I'm sure, but not good at all. Welcome to the race in 23rd position, Richard Roberts for World Connect, though. We've just had Brendan in. And there is his teammate, Richard Roberts, out there. So, team doing a good job indeed. Still 27 teams running.
I see Espen Tippel is out as well. So, nice to see even more newer names jumping into the game as well as the race progresses.
Always good
to
see.
He's been in the car for 10, 15 minutes or so, I think.
Yeah, he's now up to full amount.
What? That was close.
I don't think he'll be pleased with that, and he's not exactly helping things there as Espen Tippel laps Richard Roberts. Roberts getting himself back up to speed. Obviously, it does take a little while to get your kind of parameters intact, doesn't it, to kind of work out where everyone is, which is why there's always turn one dramas, normally at the start of a race, but we avoid that with a rolling start in single file. Excuse me. So do you have any particular favourite games that you play, Roy, apart from this, of course?
Well, I just about drive everything that is to drive on race department, so I don't have that much time to do anything else.
People are giving big shout-outs to Portal now, actually, as well. So.
Oh, Portal, great.
I'm still alive!
Fairytale Fights?
Fairy Tail Flights, yeah, that was not a bad little game.
Yeah,
it didn't really get much attention when it came out, did it? But it's quite fun.
Rusek is Peters into the pits for Hell Racing Team Hungary in P2.
Ooh, Attila Kish, let's bring him up. There he isn't.
Rusek is Peters, position 12. Leaving the pits at the moment.
Ah, sorry, I was looking at the wrong Hell team. Confusion going on. 42 second stop. So he's back off and away in 12th position. I'm going to give my shout out for most obscure best game ever to a game called Gregory Horror Show.
I heard of that.
It's fantastic. It's also a TV cartoon as well.
Yeah.
But it's seriously messed up. Love it. I will give everyone a thumbs up for that.
I'm actually closing up on the lap mark. It'll leave us around lap 97.
Oh, crumbs, so they are. Only another 10 minutes and we're there. The Centurion mark has been hit.
Woo-hoo!
That surely allows me to have a beer. Do you think I'd be allowed a beer when we get to that point? As we are approaching also the 6-hour mark. Well, not really. We've still got... I was being a bit optimistic, really, wasn't I?
I really want that baby.
A little bit optimistic, wasn't I, really? So there's Janssens for Rare Endurance Team. We've barely seen anything of the Rare Endurance Team so far this race. We better give them a little bit of airtime and loving. Zork Trilogy? Goldeneye for N64. We've mentioned that one, Dave Simmons. So that got a thumbs up, didn't it?
What if we question. What's the worst game you ever played?
Ooh! Yeah, worst games, everyone, peoples. I think the worst game I've ever played... That's quite tough, actually. Because everyone's all like, it's COD 3 or something like that, and you think it's not the worst game ever.
Well, that's actually quite a good game, actually. It's just, you have to like the series to...
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, people get the ump. I'm going to go with a game called, if I can find it in my list, I'm a games collector.
Teen Agent. I rest my case.
Teen Agent?
Yep. Teen Agent.
Why do I feel like I've played that? Well, I've got it. Look. Is that a PS2 game?
Last week.
Oh, I'm looking at Teen Titans, sorry.
Yeah, last week I bought this package where you could buy Police Quest 1, 2, 3, and 4 for about $5. And when you bought it, you got 4 games for free. And one of those games was Teen Agent.
Uh-oh.
Was it? That's all I have to say. I played it for... I think I tried it for about an hour, and I never got out of the first room.
Oh dear.
Have you ever tried Police Quest?
Oh, it's a thinking game, is it?
No.
Is that why you thought it was rubbish? Because you couldn't get it. Did you need an FAQ to get around the menu screen?
Well, if you played the old Police Quest games from the 80s, they are like you control this character around, you type in what to do, open door, pick up gun, drive car, all this. Teen Agent was a spin-off of this series. And the game is so rubbish and bad. I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, that's Robin Toll was driving the Rari Rare Endurance Porsche, wasn't he?
Yeah.
A little while ago. Then Richard Blocker has taken over the wheel there in a pit stop.
Oh, that's welcome Richard Blocker back. And there for the other Rare Endurance car, there he is. That car's been in the wars a little bit today, but it's still going in 23rd place.
Yeah, in 6th position. No, sorry, I'm looking at the wrong screen. What is it? 5th position GT2.
Yeah, not bad at all. Not bad at all. I'm now looking for this. I can't remember the name of this bloody game, and it's awful. Ninja Bread Man is the worst game I've ever played in my life.
Explain.
It's supposed to be a platform game, but it's a gingerbread man who's got like a ninja scarf on, and he has to beat up other like cookies and stuff. And it's but the controls are so bad that you can't actually really do anything. And it's just awful. And the same people that made that also made a game called I think it's Hamster Mania or something. And it's supposed to be it's a hamster ball game. And you've got to there's a hamster stuck inside a ball, and you've got to dip down mazes. But the controls are so off that it's impossible to play. And I have made videos of it to go on my YouTube channel that I run called High Plane Games, which you can all go on and subscribe to if you want to watch really crazy games and me playing them poorly. But
it's
never...
quite fun, actually.
Is it? Yeah. Have you subscribed?
I've subscribed and I watched it.
Oh, thank you. But yeah, there's There's a lot of tit on there. But where I collect games, I try and find all the weird ones. And yeah, that's just I've dared not to put the videos on there because the game is so bad that it makes me look like a really crap player for trying to play it. What about you, Joachim? Have you got any particular bad games?
Other than Teen Agents.
Oh, sorry, Roy then. I thought that was Roy saying that. That might mean. Any bad games, Roy?
He's thinking.
I'm watching the race at the same time. Sorry.
Two things at once. Can't do it, you're a man.
No, the Scroton brothers are into the pits. Bad games? No, I can't really say that I've played any ones that I really hate.
Okay. Just going through the messages on the... Excuse me, sorry about my cough. Stuff on here. We've got...
here.
I was going to say... Oh, sorry. Oscar Hardwick was saying there is a Road Sweeper Simulation 2011.
I've tried that. There also is a Road Builder Simulation where you build...
Yeah, so I thought he meant the game Dust Force, which I thought was good, and he's like, no, Dust Force is excellent. But that is road sweeping, but that's quite good. Reminds me of Super Meat Boy. There's a guarding simulator, says Jonas Hetlex. Oh dear.
All those simulators, they're actually quite good games, but
yeah.
You have to be interested.
In what it's that like, actually is.
Like, the Mario Suit tries to the ski slope simulator, what's it called? Where the ski slopes.
Oh, yeah. Like the ski tourist management stuff.
Yeah, maybe.
But, yeah, there is a sim game for all kinds of different things, though, isn't there?
Yeah.
And some of them you just think, why would
Public
that
simulator.
Ever sell? Yeah. I tell you what I do like to do, and I'm going to... Some stuff for it tomorrow. Oh, it won't let me... Did it type it in? Yes, it did. I like to import scary Japanese games. And there's one. Yeah, there is that. I've just got one called Super Businessman, and it's loads of mini games that all last for like 15 seconds each. It's a bit like WarioWare, but just more Japanese.
Like Incredible Crisis.
Oh, love Incredible Crisis.
Yeah.
And Tokyo Ska Orchestra do the soundtrack for that, and they are fantabby-doos. So.
Ooh.
Yay!
Royce, please.
Ooh. Ooh, as Rickard Helsen nearly bins it for the lead there for Turret Motorsports. He was lucky. He got up high on the curbs on the exit of whichever corner that is. I can't remember what it was, but... I can't remember the corner names around here, and there's only about five corners. The rest of it's all straight, and I still can't remember it. But he got so high up on the curves, you could see that it was starting to go, and he just collected it right at the right time. And he's just coming up towards the back in the car, Gilles Vogels, for Downforce Racing, facing the right way. Woo!
Woohoo!
And a couple of laps ago, Ryan Mayfield took over the 05 Motorsport P1 car from Michel Stenbeck.
Welcome to the race. Good job someone's keeping an eye on the race. There we go, welcome in. Ryan
and
is
Andre,
in the pits as well.
Andre Martins is into the pits in the fifth position. Or is he exiting? Yes, he is exiting the pits.
Yeah, he's just taken over, hasn't he? So that's worked out quite nicely for him. Ryan Mayfield back out in third position. Still ahead of Dennis. Porcupine for Akuri Sim Motorsport. Yeah. That's the one. And yet, and that is actually third place being lapped by the leader, and that looked, well, I don't know if that was lag there for TMO, but that looked quite scary. So here's first position, about to lap third position here at the 5.5 hour mark.
Oh, and they actually have now passed the 100 lap mark there on lap 101.
Woohoo!
everyone went quiet.
We're celebrating.
Yeah, I was just Oscar Hardwick was just saying Psychonauts is fantastic. So
I've tried it once. Don't remember it.
It's one of those games that a lot of people like to name drop, but I don't know who's actually played it. Because I've got it for the PS2, but they've just kind of rebadged it and made it a little bit better again and re-released it. But they've gone onto this website, and I've forgotten the name of the website now, but they basically, people were paying for them to then fund their next game, the game company called Double Fine. And you like set a thermometer target, and then when you hit it, they give you all of the money, and then you can do your project for it, and they were doing well.
Yeah.
That's going to really annoy me, so I'm going to find where it is. I know exactly where it, because I was chatting to someone somewhere about it. Let me find out. And can I just say that Little Big Planet is going to release a karting game? Surely that is Mod Nation Races, just in disguise.
Oh, careful in
the... Oh my goodness! That's the leader! That's the leader facing the wrong way! Rickard Helston, what happened there? That was a bungle in disguise. Let's take a look at the replay. Here comes Rickard Helston then. What was that, the replay? Have we been sat on?
It was the replay.
Oh.
Yeah.
Right, well let's take another little looky at it then. Just in reverse, sorry about this guys, but I want to see what's going on. So was he attacked from behind, or did he just lose it on his own accord? What on earth was he doing?
Reached a camera winkle. Angle. Not reached.
Well, that was silly, because he dived for the and tried to lap that car on the grass, so no wonder he was going to go off. What a moose. Sorry, Ricard. You're not a moose, really. But that was just... City driving, obviously the camera angle, I don't know whether that should be on, but we're just going back up to... Oh! What was that? Was he just in the wars again there?
That might have been replay late.
Okay. So, thankfully, he's now... So we're back live. Now actually up to scratch and going full speed again, but... Not good there for Rickard Helston, who once again facing the wrong way whilst leaving. But apparently, Oscar was just saying that that company got $1 million in 24 hours. See, and Marcel Pershk actually just thinking aloud, why do people take risks when they can wait for the next straight? It's against racing mentality to do it, though. You always end up going for the silly gaps, in general.
Yeah, that's exactly why we are racing on computers and not real life.
There is that. But... Yeah, it's and I think that's also why we are racers, because we will go for the gap regardless.
That's true. If you see a gap, try for it. But if you see it's getting too close, back off.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Okay, right. I'm looking. So at least he's going again. And things to do that. Kickstarter is the name of the website. I knew I'd find it somewhere. Any games that anyone's looking out for that's out coming soon? If anyone says R-Factor 2, that won't be this year, of course.
I bought the beta of R-Factor 2 a couple of weeks ago.
Ah, how are you finding it?
I'm not impressed.
Really? I know it's a beta, obviously, so things can change and improve.
The one thing I really don't like about the R-Factor 2 so far is the force feedback in the steering wheel.
Oh, I've heard a few people say it ripped their arms off a little bit.
Yeah.
Mortal Kombat style.
Fatality!
Yeah! Force feedbackality.
Yeah. I drove 5 or 6 minutes and then go back to R-Factor 1.
But when you've bought the beta, that means that you'll get the game once it's finished and ready to go.
Yeah, I bought the full version.
Awesome.
It's a lifetime.
I've I've purposely not bought the beta because I didn't want to be disappointed with not having the full product there and then at the start, so...
You should buy it and then the complaint.
I just saved my money. Yeah. As Akuri Motorsports are up into third position, Joel Stenbeck's in the bin in the pits, I think. Let me just double check to make sure he has. Yeah, he's done a 4 minute 29. That was an awfully long pit stop, and he slipped down to fourth. Sorry, I didn't mean to be so upset with that, but Joel Stenbeck in fourth position, who's having an awful time of traffic as well at the moment, down to fourth after a terrible pit stop. It's not working out for 05 Motorsports, once leaders of this race and looking quite juicy for the win at points, now slipping down to fourth a lap down as he completes his 100th lap. Not good at all. And into the commentary box we've got Ryan Mayfield.
Yes, just finished the shortest stint of my racing career there.
I was going to say, you've barely got your feet wet. How'd you get on?
Well, I had a lot of faith in Shell this race because he's a fantastic driver. He always does good over at the ERL. And, our very own George Talbot starts talking to him about stuff, and he misses his breaking point or something. Gets some damage. And
so George!
We're in the process of kicking George out of the team as well as the league.
Oh, so you're behind this.
Scandal, scandal.
But, yeah, the damage was just too much to let him go on, so I jumped on the game really as fast as I can and took over. And then I let the leader go by, Helston, and he made a really dodgy pass going into Indianapolis. He went through the grass, and he spooked the GT, which turned into me. I lost the splitter. Helston kept going on his merry way. So once I had that damage, I then understeered in the Porsche curves and came together with him again. He got into my rear end. So I was like, hey, Shell, you want to get back in the car and keep going?
To which he's obviously said yes, as he's just moved back up into third position, where fourth place Sergei Soldatov retakes the Akuri Sim Motorsport car. So you're back up into third for now. What do you think's going to happen now for the rest? Because you're lapped by the leading duo. Is it just damage limitation, continue aiming for third, or do you think you're going to try and do an attack back?
Well, I've been drilling this into the guys' heads. Our first race in this league, we finished fifth. Then we finished fourth. Then we got third. We can only get second or first from here. Of course, we want first. And as we just saw, over the course of 15 minutes, we lost a lap and a half. It can easily happen to the other guys.
That is very, very true. And you still have to be there to pick up the pieces. So you need to go full pelt throughout. So,
yep.
Wise words. Car. Yep. Fresh car, fresh vegetables. It's all good.
Except for our egos.
That's true. Slightly battered. And possibly George, who, now that everyone's stolen his admin whip after that comment that caused everyone to crash, I'm sure he'll be feeling the pain. So, interestingly, actually, in our discussion about games, your favourite game, your least favourite game, anything, do you have any particular favourites or ones that you would never touch with a barge pole?
There's so many to name because my parents got me into gaming when I was probably 2 or 3 years old, starting with Atari.
Wow.
And of course it all started with Pole Position for that.
Day.
I still play that to this day. Just, you know, it seemed like ahead of its time, having two gears, first and second.
Yeah.
Having a recreation of the Formula One tracks, but the worst game, any Barbie games, Hannah Montana. any movie games that are just out there to sell, you know, they really make the movie, the game industry look terrible, just trying to cash in.
Because that's when all the people that just casually buy a game go, oh, I love that film, let's go and buy that, and they go, this game is attached, and then they just won't come back for another game after. So yeah, I agree with that completely.
Yes, and I wasn't a hardcore gamer until about 10, so and whenever I saw one of those movies, I was like 8 or 9 years old. I was like, oh my god, they probably made a great game for it.
But, to be fair, I think movie tie-in games have got worse as time has gone on. Because beforehand, I mean, when you was looking at, like, a 2D platformer, Admittedly, you can get an awful lot wrong with a 2D platformer, but if it goes wrong, you just think, oh, it's slightly dodgy collision detection or something like that. It's not. It can't be so catastrophically unplayable as a 3D game, I think, in many cases.
Absolutely. And that's why our racing games nowadays take so long. It's just like how the first-person shooters take so long. They have so much more to draw. They do have bigger design studios, but not everyone does. So, like ISI being only 6 or 7 or 10 programmers taking 5 years to do a game. Back then, they could pretty much buy a game like Super Mario and completely copy it.
Definitely.
Yeah, if you guys remember Super Mario Bros. 2, where Peach could float and Luigi kind of fluttered and did all these weird things, it is because they copied a Japanese game and just relabeled it with all the Mario characters, so...
Yeah. It's funny as well, because you do kind of wonder in the end where the game industry can kind of head, especially in this kind of economic climate, because it seems that the bigger studios push for bigger, more, and then the costs almost spiral out of control to stupidity. And then they make big, huge games, and then if they don't sell, like, 3,000 million copies, then it's considered, oh, my God, I can't do with this. We can't have a new series come out, and we can't tackle anything else. We'll just call a name something and then stick a 2 on the end, or something karting or racing, or something zombie attack. God, if there's another zombie game. Do you know what, if they could do it, R Factor Zombies would be the next thing that comes out, because everything has a zombie mode these days.
Trying to run with Marvin zombies on the Mulsanne Street.
Yeah, and actually every time you hit the 10th zombie, you will get a power, you'll get like a little Kurz boost or something. You
R
know it's coming.
Getting style.
Yeah. Or Zombie Driver. That's been out on PC for not too long. And you just think, those kind of things are getting bigger and better, and it leaves almost the smaller, slightly indie developers. They almost have to go for like a niche, strange thing to try and get any headway whatsoever, and there's nothing left in the middle anymore.
Yes. Like it's a double-edged sword, I believe. The Call of Duty franchise, everybody wants to play it, which means everybody else wants to play it as well, because you don't want to be the only guy left out.
Well, I've never played one.
Well, if you're an FPS fan and you have friends in real life, then...
Oh, yeah. Are you trying to say something there?
Absolutely not, Simon. But the indie games I like, too. Because they keep it simple. They have to be creative to make a name for themselves nowadays.
Yeah.
They can't just do like everybody else and be successful.
Any particular games you'd like to name drop as ones you think stick out?
As far as innovative game, there's no way you can look past Portal.
Oh, that's true.
A sentient boss guide you, turn on you, and then tell you there's cake.
Portal 2 better than first one, but... That's most because Wheatley.
Wheatley was good. Yes, both of those games were fantastic.
Yeah,
good character. Good character. Yeah, no, agreed. Great stuff. I'm going to chip in audio, sir. Anyone's ever played that?
I thought that was a software or application.
Kind of. Yeah, you could. It borders that kind of app/. Game thing, where obviously it takes your music and turns it into a playable level that you've got to collect the blocks on as you go around. But as someone that collects a lot of music, it's fun for me to lose far too many hours on it. So, Limbo is one that lots of people seem to name drop, but I found that quite limiting, actually. Yeah. That's just basically someone saying, oh my god, I can't be bothered to colour in the screen.
Yeah.
It's one of those, you know when you get like certain films, everyone goes, oh, well, you've got to love this because it's so highbrow, blah, 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 blah. And I think actually, but it's not, it's like watching art for the sake of you saying I'm so arty, when actually it's not fun. As welcome to the race, Mark Urban for 25 Motorsports in 20th position, new name.
Yes, those guys in the GT, I swear they have all the luck. I want to drive the GT car now.
You just need a touch and stroke Wilfried van der Brink.
He is our single weapon.
Stroke.
Yeah.
He's going, hurr.
Not in that way.
Well, no, but if he's got the Midas touch, then he might pass some of the luck to you.
Yeah, I definitely want to be his friend, just for the sake of being faster.
Friend!
It seems like being closer to him means you're a little bit less drag, more horsepower. For the 24-hour race, I was asking Steve, hey, can I be in Wilfred's team? Can I be with Wilfred? What car is Wilfred in? Can I be in that one?
Please!
And the leader is in the pits.
Let's catch up with them. Hello, Ricard. How's it? In after a couple of dodgy moves. I know you mentioned it earlier that he'd overtaken someone on the grass. We saw him basically bin it after trying to lap someone on the grass. So he's fast, but he's not always doing himself a great lot of favours, but he does have the gap to do it. John Davis has already been in second position for Atlantic Racing Team. So this is looking like a long stop, so definitely tyres being changed.
Hopefully a mismatch.
And drivers too. Hello, Petter. Petter with the Peter.
Aww. I did see that Kevin Ledoux is in the pits as well.
In 10th place, Casper Mortensen has taken over them in a TAMS International car. TAMS still going, obviously. So, great stuff. Still 27 teams going. Let's continue as slowly, just giving a quick bit of everyone down the order. There's Richard Roberts in 22nd.
And for once, my car is a part of those who are still going.
Woo-hoo. That is...
and it's still
Team Roy! Yay!
Team Roy goes blasting off again!
Oh dear. Awesome stuff. So... I know, it's always, I do love to listen to other people's games opinions and stuff like that. I always find it really, really interesting, so thank you very much for that. Good stuff. What's your plans then for the rest of the event? Oh, someone in the barriers just out of the corner of my eye there. Was that Renus by any chance? Or was it? No, not Renus. Someone was off.
Please be Casa.
No. They hit the wall, whoever that was, unless it was lag. It may have just been lag.
24. Vogels.
Who? Oh, Vogels.
It's 24. Off the track.
Downforce Racing Teams, Joel Vogels, not looking good.
And they've changed the livery on the car again.
Like trying to find a lucky one.
Yeah, well, they were using that beautiful yellow and blue one earlier in the season. And yes, it was red and green
that.
The last time around.
Yeah.
Now it's red and blue.
Well, none of them are giving them any luck, because every time we see Zhao, he's facing the wrong way in general, so he's had an interesting couple of stints.
No front bumper, no bonnet on that car either.
I haven't been on front bumper on that car since lap 10, I think.
I did try that no bumper in the front thing with my P1. It didn't work as well as it does with the P2s.
Yeah, someone was saying in the chat room that actually with a P2 with no front bumper, you gain an extra 10 kph.
Yeah, down the street you do.
Yeah, I guess the P1s are a different story. Which, I thought it was worth trying.
Much to your shock, by the sounds of it. Oh dear. So, okay. So, any particular... Oh, no, don't mind me. Carry on regardless. Sorry, I was I was getting lag. And I was like, someone's in the wall! But they're not. So. We need a restart.
Yeah, actually. It's 2 hours since last time.
So, what we should do, stay tuned. We will disappear off the stream for about 30 seconds or so, just while we restart everything for the fun that is YouTube. And stay with us here on simracing.tv for some more RDLMS action coming up soon.
Miss you.
Hugs and kisses. Oh.